the kitchen.
Taking down that actual wall where you can actually see through.
There's so much more light in the dining room now.
Yeah, it changed the dining room as much as it changes the kitchen. What do you think?
Did it all fall in the basement?
Yeah.
I feel like I'm in a horror movie.
But they've made a lot of progress.
What's the situation with Little Door?
The situation is it's the best part about this house.
Oh. Yeah, what are we going to do about Little Door?
Hear me out. Imagine if we did wainscoting all the way around the room that was this height, and then this door disappears. Here, you put a panel that's hinged. You walk up and you press it, and it pops out. It's a secret door to a secret room.
I got it.
So then when we bring the Warrens up here, we're like, oh my gosh, check out your master.
We got rid of the little door.
Psych.
Just ka-chow. Kidding. Like that?
But I'm not going to do that, but I'd be like, whoopah.
Okay.
Just think about it. You don't have to decide
today. I
think
we just have to make it cool.
But I think it would work.
If you look close, the shingles do not come out past the fascia board.
Right.
Which, when the water comes off, it just comes right down on the wood and sits there. And as you can see where we're standing, there's some obvious
issues. We knew this was rotten, but it's causing leaks.
It's causing leaks.
Dang. So what are our options?
One would be do a little patchwork. No guarantee that'll actually stop the water if it
hardly
does.
Hardly ever works,
yeah.
Does it?
How long is it gonna last? The other option would be rip the roof off, put a brand new one on.
Yeah, that's way outside their budget, but it rains a lot in Mississippi.
And you need a roof every single time.
At first, when we talked about the roof, the idea was to just start over, basically. But then Jonathan noticed that it's not quite as bad as we thought. It was mostly just the flashing around the second floor.
We're gonna take the bottom run of siding off, reflash that. That'll take care of the leak issue.
Well, and that way we're buying them some time on getting a new roof and at the same time saving the work that we're doing to the house.
Yeah.
The kitchen is looking killer at the Warren House.
They're painting cabinets. It still needs a lot of work, but you can see it.
And it looks expensive in there.
Mm. The rest of the house is looking awesome. The wainscoting and the secret door are coming together.
Do you think this is like gonna actually work, Adam?
Oh yeah, the door's gonna be great. That's gonna be the coolest thing in the house.
The coolest part about the house.
All right, I'm a believer, baby.
Paint's looking awesome. I thought we were keeping this color.
You were mistaken.
This is a huge difference. I mean, I don't want to say it's like black and white, but it's definitely like green and white. I mean, it's shaping up to be one of my most favorite houses. You guys remember the Chancellor House?
Yes. We needed a ton of work.
Oh, yeah. Welcome to the Warren House.
Oh my gracious.
I can't believe it's the same house. Like, it's your house.
It looks amazing.
Man, look at the front porch.
The biggest thing, we pulled all the screen off.
Yes.
So, that makes a big difference.
Yeah, so now
it looks so much bigger.
The porch is open.
Yeah.
We cleaned out all the old landscaping, put in new.
We wanted to make your front porch feel like a living room.
Yeah.
Yes. That is the front porch I always wanted. I can't wait to sit out here.
Everybody in the neighborhood is thrilled about this house. So
good.
You're probably going to have to invite them over at some point. Or they may just invite themselves.
That's fine, too.
You want to go inside?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Go in.
Oh, my gracious.
Oh, my gosh. What is this place? This is your house.
Can you believe that? This looks incredible. Oh, there's no way this is the same green room.
That's incredible. Love the tile work on the fireplace.
Right when you walk in, it draws your eye.
Color scheme, the inspiration for your entire house came from your fireplace tile.
Okay.
Look at the rafter up there above the doorway.
Was that there before?
No, it wasn't.
Okay.
It's so just airy and clean.
I love it. I love it.
I can't wait to show you the dining room.
It looks so different. It was so closed in.
Yeah.
I know it. Everything feels so much more open now.
I know.
Look at that light fixture. I love that.
I do too. And this color, I love how it ties in with everything else in the house. It's not bruised brown anymore.
There's so much space to entertain in here.
And we frosted your laundry room doors and windows. You have all the light, but none of the laundry.
That's right. That helps a lot better.
Yeah. Let's look at your kitchen over here.
Oh, my gosh. What was this kitchen before? I mean, I can't stop. I mean, this is incredible.
It's the best kitchen we've done yet.
I think so, too.
I don't think Brooke likes the kitchen.
Brooke, this is your dream kitchen you've been waiting on.
I love the colors. It's so light and airy.
And this countertop looks incredible.
I know. Look at this hardware. I love it.
Yeah, we wanted to have little accents of copper throughout the house to tie in with the fireplace mm-hmm. colors.
And the backsplash is incredible.
Have you seen the breakfast nook?
I know.
This is an old church pew that we took to the shop and sectioned and then just attached it to the walls.
That's amazing.
I love that. The church pews, I love.
I love it.
They look a lot like the pews that were in the church that we come from in Nashville, and so it's a good touch to remind us of that.
We kept this pitch from the staircase and then mimicked it on this side and added some millwork, and then we kept this piece that was already here, but we wrapped it in copper to tie it to the rest of the house.
I love this countertop on it. It really breaks up the monotony of the white that was there.
This is a great kitchen.
It's my favorite room in the house.
You haven't even seen upstairs yet.
That's true. I forgot there was more to see. I can't believe there's more than this.
These stairs are beautiful.
So we refinished all of it.
Oh, it was exposed brick.
Yep.
Oh, man.
There was a chimney hiding behind plaster.
I'm so glad that was there. This is actually usable space now.
It looks so good.
What a great sitting area right here.
Do you want to see one more room? Your bedroom?
Yes.
Delicious.
Oh my gosh! It's exactly the color I had in mind. I mean,
really?
It really is. I can't even believe we're in the same place.
Know it. Perfect, open, bright feeling that we wanted.
Before you had one closet?
Yes.
Now you have a his and
now
her.
Now we have two.
Closet situation.
Are they both the same size?
I think so.
I think they're roughly the same.
Just in case, I'm gonna take the bigger one.
Yeah.
But I love the wainscoting around it.
I do too.
The wainscoting, it turned out really good. It doubles because it does really tie it to the craftsman architecture of the house. But more importantly, you notice there's panels all the way around the room. And then...
What?
You believe it? It's perfect.
This is amazing. I forgot that door was there.
Oh, man.
The wainscoting is hilarious.
Kyle totally got it.
He was on board. He was drinking the Kool-Aid of the secret door.
Yeah, he was, because that's some fine Kool-Aid. Got a touch latch, so you just...
That's perfect.
Isn't that awesome?
Yes.
I knew you would love this.
I love it. That's my favorite part. If Brooke has the kitchen...
This is you. I fought for this.
And you're my hero for it.
You want to try it?
I do. Oh, that's good.
Nice.
That's good. Mm. That's good stuff there.
Can you imagine playing hide and go seek?
You win every time.
You win every time. Because you come in here and they chase you and then...
You're gone. You just disappeared.
Where did you go?